Hey guys, Taki here. 2 days ago, I did a video on this little guy. This is the AMOLED screen that I turned into a pseudo handheld, and it caused a bunch of outrage from people that were angry about a mix of things, from this not being a handheld or not fitting the definition of a handheld, to angry about this being tethered to another device and not being truly portable. So in this video, we're going to solve a few of those issues, but I first want to start off by talking about why I did this project in the first place. I've been doing YouTube for about 3 years now, and the majority of my time doing this goes into testing and evaluating early samples that I get from several companies that are making handhelds or are thinking about making handhelds. Even though this gives me early access to some interesting technology before there are any retail products using it, it can be kind of frustrating at times. Those products are usually very early in development. At that point, you typically only have an engineering PCB from the main chipset company with very rough software. You usually do not get any stuff like screens or anything in the way of working controls until very long into development. Even something as simple and rudimentary as what I have here would be something that you'd only see after investing a significant amount of money. Sometimes even when you do have something this simple, you still have many months to wait for basic software issues to be fixed. If we use Udon as an example, that screen wasn't really fixed until late last year, and some people would say that it wasn't really fixed until just recently. Because of stuff like that, I always feel strange testing out something that is not a handheld that will eventually be a handheld in an application scenario where it is not operating as a handheld. In some cases, I could go through the process of creating a quick streaming solution with something like an Android phone to get a rough idea of how things would be. And I have to say, I am fully aware that streaming is a thing. I've made 2 guides on this channel doing exactly that, so this is not news to me. I am also a big advocate of people going through the process as a way to recycle some of their older tech that they have lying around if they want to get into handhelds at a low price point. But doing something like that is not always possible depending on hardware and software limitations of the things that I am testing, and it can be kind of a hassle to go through that whole process of getting everything going if you have to test a bunch of different hardware all at the same time with a time crunch. That pushed me to want to create a standardized thing that I could use to test out hardware that I get on the back end to get a rough idea of how something functions as a handheld at the earliest point possible when I can't make it into a handheld in any other way. So that's what started this project, and that's why I made this thing. Because of the issues that I just described, I actually have a lot of prototypes in my studio right now of products that haven't released yet that only exist as something like this. The only exception is that they were made by the manufacturer and not by me. These would be things like devices with working screens and fake shells, or other things of that nature. These kinds of things are easy to make, and they give you some valuable insight into whether or not a concept can work before you start investing a lot of money. That's what I wanted to do here for myself. The first thing that I was planning on using this for was to create an RK3588S handheld, because that is something that is slowly coming around to the market, and it is something that I'm very excited to see, but I don't have any idea of how that's going to feel in a handheld with the heat that it generates, or the kinds of performance that we can expect without the fans being too loud when they are held in your hand. Those are things that I don't know, and they are things that I want to start testing to get a head start instead of just waiting around for the first handhelds to release. So that's the full background behind this project, and that's also why you saw me talking about putting an RK3588 SBC on the back of the first version that I was trying to create before I shifted over to doing a tethered option. Now, I like the thing that I've made because it solves the problem that I had. It's a unique problem, and again, this entire thing is super niche, but it's a problem that I've had to deal with for a long time, and I wanted to share the process with people in case there were other hobbyists out there that wanted to do something similar. It's just supposed to be a simple DIY video, not look at this thing that I did that's so amazing. It's just like, it's something that's possible, and you could do it too if you wanted. The new wireless solution from Peak 2 that I just did a video on does all of this and then some, and I could have eventually done what they did in my own project, but it's not worth investing my time because they've already solved my unique problem better than I could do without a significant time investment. They did a lot of stuff that I don't even want to bother doing, and that's why I left my project as a tethered one because it was good enough for me. There are obviously people that are angry that I called this a handheld because it's tethered, even though I'm playing it in my hands right now, Or saying things like you can spend $100 on this and get a 3070, which is not something that I said. That's just a hardware that I have around me that I was already working on. My whole point was to use stuff that you already have to create a handheld out of it, not to go out and buy something to feed this project. And for the record, the main PC that I use for everything has a GTX 1060 that I bought like 4 years ago for another YouTube channel that I had, so I'm not trying to flex. Even though I can get better stuff as a YouTuber now, 9 times out of 10, I will just use something that I bought with my own money because it has way more value to me than something that I got for free. Nevertheless, we are going to finish this project by making this thing portable with the same $100 budget that I had in my first video. If you managed to see the end of that video, you will know the other controller that I bought and this screen came out to around $80. I have $20 left, and I fully intend to make this into a portable handheld, or as close as possible to a general idea that people have for a handheld. This is going to be a handheld no matter how dumb it ends up being, and it's still going to be under $100, like I said. The problem is that we do not have a lot of money left to work with. The first thing is we need a processor that can power our screen with an HDMI signal, and we also need a battery to power the processor and the screen. $20 doesn't leave us a lot of room, but whatever, we are going to do it. The best thing that I could use for this would be the Orange Pi Zero 2. This launched for $19 and I got it when it was brand new, but it isn't that cheap anymore. I could probably solve the battery situation with another dollar, and the performance from this is pretty decent with a lot of room for expansion from cloud gaming. It has HDMI out and it has another USB port that we might be able to use to power the screen, but I'm not sure. We could attach this to the back of the controller and try to find a square battery to finish this project. The problem is that I fried this a few months ago when a screw went rogue, so this is just a paperweight. These things also go for $22 now, so that doesn't help. I could probably get the company to sell me another one for $19, but that kind of defeats the purpose, and we could probably get something better than this. Without that board, we are really only down to two other options. The cheapest thing that we could use is the Raspberry Pi Zero W. We need the W variant because we have a Bluetooth controller. Now, this can be kind of hard to get and a little pricey depending on where you live, but I used to live next to a micro center and I could go in and get these for MSRP with the policy that you could only buy one of each. I would buy a Zero and Zero W whenever I went, and I would just sell them for cost plus shipping on eBay to try and help out other people that live in areas that can't get them cheap. This is one that I bought for MSRP, and if I was to use it now, it's a sunk cost because I bought it years ago. I don't have the package for this one, but I do have packages for the regular $5 version, even though I bought them back in 2019. So it is possible to get them for MSRP, and that would give me a bit more room to work with for the battery. The problem is that the Zero isn't that good for a handheld, and the AMOLED screen would be kind of wasted with the power that's in here. We could probably do some streaming, but there's not a whole lot to work with on a Zero. Up from here would be the Zero 2 with an MSRP of $15. That would leave us with a whole $5 left over for a battery, and this one is a big step up from the Zero. It's kind of close to an Orange Pi Zero 2, but it doesn't generate as much heat, and it's smaller. This is the board that I'm going with because it's the best option that I have. We do have some things that we need to worry about. The annoying thing that we need to deal with using our last $5 is the fact that the Zero 2 still has these old USB connectors just like the original one did. That's a problem because our screen uses a Type-C connector, and I want to power it from the Pi without having to go out and buy a random USB cable that I will never need to use. So, we need to find a battery that can output USB Type-C and USB Micro at the same time, which is going to be a challenge. This FlyDigi controller doesn't fit in my budget, but I just want to give you an idea of what I want to do. I essentially want to try and get the Pi in this way to leave this area here for a battery without ruining the grip. Or we could just put the battery in the center and put the Pi on top of it with the cables going this way. It just depends on what I can find. Lucky enough, I was able to find a store close to me with a random-ass charger that had both of these connectors for $5. The problem is that it's a huge battery, but it was the smallest one that I could find with these two cables. Even though this is thick with two C's now, beggars can't be choosers because these requirements were way too specific and we only had $5 to work with. I'm just happy that I was able to find something so I didn't have to MacGyver a random lipo pouch to make this work. This is a 10,000 milliamp hour battery, which is way too big for a Pi Zero 2. We are talking about over a day of battery life just playing Super Nintendo, but it works. So right now, I have this hooked up with some tape on the back of the controller. Even though it's thick, this whole thing isn't that heavy. It's situated right in the middle, more or less, and you can see it is pretty big. Obviously, it would have been good to find something thinner than this, but the things that I was able to find for $5 seemed like they were bigger than my entire controller. Anyway, I can't complain. It's 10,000 milliamp hours, and it has these stupid connectors, and it seems to work well. So what we're gonna do now is we are going to take our Pi 02, and I'm thinking about mounting it here to the side because that allows us to run the cables this way, and then we can power the unit with this one, and then we can run the HDMI cable to the side. Now, I have just enough money to do this. This is just a hair under $100. We don't have enough money for an SD card, so I'm just going to use a junk SD card that I got for free with a handheld that I never used because it's crap. We only have $100. If we had $105, this would look much better. We are doing the meme and making this thing completely portable now, no matter how dumb it looks. It will still be under $100 with an AMOLED screen, and it will now be a more widely accepted definition of a handheld. So, here's the moment of truth. We've already got everything ready to go, and I just need to find out how to turn on the battery. My controller should work because I paired it before I put this together. I've also added a bunch of games to this, and they should all work. I've also installed the Pixel desktop to this, and I've also installed Moonlight, so we could stream on this if we wanted. Anyway, that's where I'm going to close this book on the AMOLED handheld. It's portable, it has a great screen, and it plays Doom. What more could you ask? As I've already pointed out, the tethered option works perfectly for the problem that I originally had, but there are now better commercial options available that I will use going forward. I hope you guys enjoyed this extremely serious video. Happy gaming, everyone. Taki out.